Hello, my name is Mark Chinesque. I'm a Senior Application Engineer with Siler Design Solutions. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the new trim command in AutoCAD 2021. Now, it's changed a little bit since previous versions of AutoCAD, in where I don't have to select the cutting plane that I want to trim to, and I could just trim an object directly to the nearest object it finds. Let me demonstrate. In this drawing, let's say I wanted to trim this left-hand line to the circle. I'll start the trim command, and all I have to do is come down and hover over that line. You can see I get a preview of the trim, and all I have to do to execute it is select my left mouse button, and the trim command completes. Selecting enter exits the command. That's fine if I have large objects and a small number of items to go through, but what about the right side situation? I want to trim this line back to the large circle as well, but I have all these small circles in the way. If I start the trim command, you could see that trimming only trims the object back to the next object it can find. I have to sit here and trim multiple times to get that line back to the big, large circle. I have a couple options that will help, though. Let me exit the command and start over again. If I start the trim command, you can see in the command line I have some options: cutting edges, crossing, mode, projection, and erase. It's the cutting edge object option that I'm interested in. If I select cutting edges, it acts like the previous versions of AutoCAD in its trim functionality. It's asking me to select an object to trim to. I would select that, press enter, then I can select the object that I want to trim, and it acts and trims accordingly. Let me undo that and show you one more option that I have. Let's say I wanted to repeat this functionality over and over again. I can use the option trim extend mode. If I set that to 0, hit enter, and start the trim command, it immediately asks me to select the object I want to trim to. Then I can hit enter and then trim the object to that object. And that's it. And that's a persistent option that I can keep from drawing to drawing. And that's it. That's the new functionality of the trim command. The extend command works in a similar fashion, and I hope this explains things that you can do and any options you have to go back to previous functionality. If you have any questions, please email me at mchinesque@siler-ds.com, or you can email us at cadtechnical@silerinst.com. Please subscribe to our blog at www.siler-ds.com/blog for more tips, tricks, and news for Autodesk, GeoSlam, drones, and other items. Thank you and have a great day.